Hello friends, welcome to my super learning channel. Today we are going to see how to use OneNote for the mathematical calculation purpose. Hope you would have remembered in one of my previous sessions how to use the basic math calculation. Now I am going to give a brief on how to use this. Just before that, just want to recap, hope you would have been familiar with creating a OneNote book, and you can add a section by clicking here at the bottom. Once you create a section, you can add pages. This is pretty much similar to our physical books. Okay, so as many pages you can add, in previous sessions we would have seen all these. Okay, now I am moving on to the current section and the math page. So just go and enter the formula. Say for example, I want to sum these two numbers. So 3 plus 4 equal. If I hit the space bar or the enter key, it immediately calculates the formula and the results. Okay. So let us do some more calculations. The square root of 4. You could see how fast it calculates. And if you want to use little complex calculations, we already have these symbols available. So you can go ahead and use that. So I am going to use pi into 4. This has given me the result. And then if I want to divide a number, so the same formula that you use in simple calculator, you can use this. And with OneNote 2016, we have some of the new features available in the latest OneNote edition. Let me demonstrate that. The new feature with the latest OneNote application is that you can create your formula using the draw tools. Say for example, I pick one of the brush from the draw tab and then I'm going to draw my formula. X plus 2 root square. Going to evaluate this formula. So we all know this is the picture we have drawn and how I can transfer this into the mathematical formula and then evaluate this. So again I go back and select an arrow so that I can pick and select this section. Now you could see this ink part can be. Now when I select the draw tab, you could see there is a math option available, which is only available with the latest version. And when I click this, you could see there is a panel open at the right where it is prompting me to select the formula. Now I am going to hit the math button. So this is evaluating my formula. You could see now I can see what action I need to take. So in this case, I need to solve for x. As soon as I select this, it is showing up the result. So if you want to learn more steps, it will show at the bottom of the evaluated formula, and then you can understand by going through this what are the steps you need to follow to achieve the result. So once I am done with the evaluation, I can just drag and drop my results. So how easy it is to do the complex math using the math option available with the OneNote. I hope you may find useful, and since I am using the web version, at times you may have problem. This option may not be shown always. You could see the draw tab doesn't have this math option. So as a workaround, we need to switch to the simplified ribbon once, and again we need to uncheck so that it gets enabled. And you can practice as much as formulas, any complex formulas, and even it helps you to draw the linear graphs and all using the complex evaluation techniques. If you have enjoyed this session, please like, share and give a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you have already not subscribed to it. Thanks friends. See you in the next lecture. Bye.